Hello and welcome to Z-Axis. Today we're going to look at the pick and place process for surface mount technology PCB assembly. But first, a quick look at the beginning. It starts with our electrical engineers designing a circuit. Then a designer creates a board layout showing part placement and routing of traces that connect them. And from this layout, we procure printed circuit boards with a circuit printed on them. A corresponding stencil, and all of the components. And now we're ready to begin SMT assembly. These are our high-mix SMT assembly lines with pick-and-place machines from Mycronic, formerly MyData. They're optimized for flexibility to quickly change from one project to the next and do a high mix of low to mid-volume runs efficiently. These newest machines are quite fast, and they're narrowing the gap between high-mix and high-speed manufacturing. Okay, to get started, we use the stencil and a stencil printer to put a layer of solder paste on the metal of the printed circuit board. The solder paste is tiny beads of metal solder in a tacky, mildly corrosive flux that adheres to the metal and removes any oxidation. Then the board goes into the pick and place machines that, yes, pick and place the parts. Hollow nozzles use vacuum to pick up parts and then place them down into the solder paste. Here, the nozzles pick up to 8 parts at one time, place them, and come back for more. Another set of nozzles over here is doing the same thing. As soon as one group of parts is down, the next group is right there and ready to place, while the other head goes off to pick up more. The most frequently used parts are loaded near the placement area. Modern machines like this one can handle a wide range of parts of all sizes, picking up one small part per nozzle, or using multiple nozzles to pick up larger parts. That red flash is the machine vision system. With each flash, it takes multiple pictures, one of each part. And the machine uses that information to rotate and translate each nozzle independently so that every part is perfectly aligned to the board within microns. The machine vision system can also detect any visual part defects, like bent leads. Different part feeders handle the different types of the component packages: reels for higher volume parts, tube feeders for larger parts, and trays for things like BGAs. This automated tray handling system allows us to load many trays so the machine can run longer without manual intervention. Every feeder has a barcode, which we associate to the barcode on the reel when it's loaded. This gives us really powerful capabilities for part traceability. We can store manufacturer and date code of every part on every SMT assembly we produce, either by batch or by individual board. Software plays a big part in the efficiency of the pick-and-place lines. For example, here we're using two machines in series to fully place each board. Using input from the board layout files, the Mycronic software balances the line, that is, it determines which parts to place with each machine for the highest efficiency. Line control software helps with workflow planning. Say we have 6 jobs to run today on 4 machines. The software determines which machines to use for each job and optimizes the job sequence for efficiency. It makes good use of kitting and part commonality to minimize feeder loading. The Mycronic and MyData SMT lines have the fastest changeover in the industry. At Z-Axis, the redundant lines and the flexibility of the system lets us respond to last-minute customer demand changes and allows our design engineers to easily drop in prototype runs for new products. And that's a quick look at the pick-and-place process. Now the placed boards will go through the reflow oven to melt the solder and burn off the flux. Then the solder will harden to bond the components into place and form the electrical connections. After that, a lot of different things could happen to finish the assembly. It might go through the SMT process again for the second side, or have through-hole components added by machine or by hand. It will be cleaned if needed and inspected, depaneled, go through burn-in, maybe get a conformal coating, and be packaged for shipment. See the video description for links to related videos on these topics, or contact Z-Axis to learn more.